is about obviously being brave and talking about love, basically, and that love is only for the brave.
What did you just say, Liam?
I'm Louis.
Louis, oh my God, I never meant to do that.
Look back in however many years when we're granddads and we look back on the band, and I just hope that we look back on it and think we had the most amazing time and actually that we stayed true to ourselves. Last one that we picked.
Oh yeah, it is close, but you have got the shortest there, Tomlinson.
Louis, get silly string.
Okay, so we just want to say a massive thank you to everybody who voted, and we love our fans, and this tastes disgusting. Thank you. Sorry we couldn't be there.
See ya.
Some guy has asked me for a photo, literally. And I'm like, I mean, maybe wait till I've put me knob away, you know what I mean?
Shit!
Because we're both, I think I'm a nice guy, and I think sometimes people overlook us nice dudes, but we're coming.
Yeah,
and
oh yeah. Oh so yeah, and that. We will fuck you up.
Texting me, I'm a bad man, what's my name, Nile?
One Direction, hello.
Hello.
Welcome
hello.
To Free Radio. So,
good idea.
Thank you.
X Factor Live Finals. Since then, you've had number one singles, albums, awards, sold out tours internationally, cracked America, millions of fans. Not a bad couple of years, really.
It's been quite good. Yeah.
Not too shabby. So it all started on the X Factor, of course. What do you reckon to this year's lot? It's off your second album, Take Me Home, which is out in November. What can we expect from your new album? You have on tour for when you're doing that, or how? Because obviously, if you're doing it all the time, they must go through certain things.
When we did our first performance, we did like a little thing, like a little huddle thing, and like a few other little details that we'd.
I love that. You got to do something about
that. They're really rock and roll.
Are you going to sort of slip decent messages in there?
That's it.
Sorry, yeah. I just got very thrown. We're using the phones in the studio. Have you dialed one of the workers here?
It says do not dial 9, so. Dad, night.
All of the things I do.
Bianca. Oh, there we go.
Okay, How to Save a Life by The Fray.
This is a good one. I don't know the words to that one.
It's all right.
Louis, quickly, because of you, my parents have a daughter that's still alive, so thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Especially indoors. Birds indoors is the most horrible thing ever.
I love
them. Okay.
You just hear them flapping, it makes my heart.
What were they doing?
I love
Okay. I saw that you recently helped a guy to fix his hard drive by telling him to turn it on and off. Classic.
Is that
this guy right here?
This is the guy.
This guy right here. Yeah.
This is the guy to
Jordan.
Work, mate.
Jordan, come
Jordan.
Over here.
Come on,
come on, Jordan.
Come on down.
Come on, Jordan. Just stand there. So this is the man behind the hard drive fixed, is it?
I'm that mate who loves to wind people up, you know what I mean? So I saw that Jordan was very, very distressed and that he'd you'd lost quite a lot of work, hadn't you, Leonard?
Yeah.
I found it pretty funny. I thought I'd send him a little tweet and tell him to do the on-off job. Because it always irritates me when someone says that. Mm-hmm. Did it irritate you, lad?
Yeah.
Yeah, it did.
Yes. Words of wisdom from Louis Tomlinson.
I think any, if you ever have a worry with technology, just turn it on and off.
Thank you so much. And I love all the signs you just had for that one there, the till the end signs. But we're going till the end as well. The promise.
I love you! What's
this here? It's a really good one. No, really, you have been an amazing crowd. I want to say thank you so, so much. You've been absolutely beautiful. So thank you. We're going to move on. Tom, what are you filling up there?
Okay.
Yeah, you with the water gun. What's that for? We're not having this show out.
I'm
going to
get down with this one.
You're going to get down with that one? No, you've got it coming, mate. You've got it coming.
Thanks, love.
Can you raise something cute, baby?
What it
is. Anything.
What constitutes cute? There you go. Fuck. Oh.
So, it's like drugs?
It's better than drugs, Jeremy.
I know what you're chasing. You can only get this feeling from.
Don't look that way.
Yes, yes.
This dog must be so scared.
No, he's loving it. Can we get a picture with all of them? Wait, can you get a picture? Wait.
Alright.
Can we?
I'm alright. Yeah,
close.
Oh,
here.
Oh, shit.
Thank you.
Can you restate this?
Yeah,
I saw you 2 weeks ago.
I was just about to say I am pretty bad at that, but I'll try.
Yeah, because I'm sure it finishes the washing machine.
You told me you won't.
Yeah. I know, but I'm really unorganized. I try my best.
Charlie wants the Pringles. Okay. Thank you. Louis, show us your... That's me there. Show us your bum. Oh, there is... Wait, look at that. Show me there. That's it. Show me there.
Over mob movies or mob movies over war movies?
Honestly,
zero.
For like the last 30 seconds, I didn't really get a lot of that. That was very quick.
Did a little stick figure there, me and Louie, LOL.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. That's cute. Forgot your name though, love. But yeah, the picture's nice.
You know what I mean? I obviously like to have me. Right, honestly. Any more laughing? Any more laughing? Yeah. You know you'll get kicked out if you carry on. Hey.
Oh, we have people behind us.
Final warning.
Can they... Yeah, that's that. What are you shouting today?
This is a tough one.
Can't hang with yourself for so long over there.
Time to. We've been One Direction, we have a couple of things left. This is Little White Lies.
I've come across some before on Twitter and I think it's utterly bizarre, some of it, to be honest.
Is that a real word? Saxophonist?
Yeah, I think so.
Wow.
It's personally played saxophone. Saxophonist?
Is it? I'm looking around the room.
It is?
Yeah.
Well,
then.
I mean, no one really likes to talk about money, obviously. Just shift it off to me, Mum. There we go.
Hello everyone, it's Louis. First of all, I wanted to say that I'm thinking of all of you. I wanted to send you a personal message to wish you all well in this terrible time. I hope you're looking after yourselves, and looking after each other, and staying at home. But please be patient, be kind, and take care of each other. With more weeks in lockdown, it's even more important than ever that we keep this spirit going and rally round to support the most vulnerable. Sending you loads of love.
What's the big lad called? You know what I mean? The main man.
The T-Rex?
The T-Rex. Yeah. I'd probably have to say him. Yeah. Like there's one. Yeah.
And I'm here in America till about the 20th, around then. I shouldn't really be telling everyone dates. Jesus, that's a first.
I owe them a lot, you know? I really
do. It really sounds like you do. Yeah, fucking hell. Jesus.
You know what?
I hope you don't owe me a lot. You know?
Do that one more time, you'll be disqualified. Right now.
No!
Kill the lights, so baby, close your eyes. The way you're looking at me, you got me mesmerized. Something I can't escape, feel like I'm lost in space. You got that good loving, girl, if you leave me, I might throw my heart away. You
know. Everyone is gonna die and no one is gonna remember you, so fuck it.
One as well. There you go. There you go.
When we come back, a performance from Steve Aoki and Louis Tomlinson. You don't want to miss it.
In it looks
different person.
Yeah, it is. You're a lot sweeter, this lad.
When I was coming in the door, you were shouting out the car at someone.
Yeah, I wondered if you heard that. Yeah, one of those stupid little immature things, you know what I mean? Every now and then, I mean, I've carried that since the band, you know what I mean? You get locked up all day and then you end up being immature a little bit. So, yeah, just trying to make people jump outside the car. It's a blacked out window, so seeing a few people think they might be getting robbed, but it's only me shouting. It was funny, it was funny. I didn't get you though,
didn't
I?
No, you didn't. I'm that would have been funny. Any other little pranks?
Anything that's like harmless, but might annoy people a little bit, you know what I mean? That can be quite fun, like making people jump right now. Yeah, I'm really upset for you people. But it was funny, you know?
It was funny.
To be the sun, the literal light and life source of the world. Louis, that is a big one.
It's quite a responsibility for a start, yeah. I've never heard that one before, but it feels great to hear that. Making the fans feel included is very, very important to me.
My fans are the best fans in the world.
I think I got some extra special people. They are like super dedicated and super loyal. Surprises me every time as well, and the level of dedication from them is it's amazing. And it's really cool. I mean, they are like that. They are like.
When I was back at school, like this time last year, a year and a half ago, I, this is so funny, I used to, when I used to be really hard up for money, drive to the local Tesco, and if a sandwich, for example, goes out of date that day, you get one of these stickers, reduced, or in other places, whoopsies, little whoopsie stickers.
Whoops.
Anyway, I realised that basically, if I had one of these stickers from another sandwich, but I really wanted this other sandwich that actually didn't go out of date for another 2 days, I could peel off this sticker, put it on another sandwich, and then, with the 55 pence that I've got in my pocket, I can pick up a sausage and egg sandwich. very mischievous, very bad.
The crinkles. The stone for your thighs. The dimples.
She needs that extra 5 minutes ahead. Come on.
I promise you, our next song is the last one, and then you can leave then. Deal?
Watching you.
What a woman. What a woman.
Reese's Puffs, eat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up. Reese's Puffs.
I have four nipples.
No, that's Harry. Harry has four nipples. I know that for a fact. It's false.
Hang on a minute. Have you seen my nipples?
Okay, that is a good point.
When we're going to hear some new music as well.
So it's January 29th.
29th of 2020.
Yeah, that's right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's okay.
31st, 31st. Everyone's laughing because I got it wrong earlier today. I said 22nd. I just went with a week forward. 31st. I'm getting nods. Yeah, so the album
January.
I've been waiting for, Fred.
Aisha. Okay. Saying, I am an aspiring singer, but a terrible songwriter. Do you have any tips in becoming more confident in your writing?
Well, there's certainly a lot of singers that don't do no writing, so you might be all right. any tips for a songwriter? I would say be honest and try and use your emotions as much as you can. And once something happens that you feel is poignant and interesting in your life, write about it, because they're the most interesting parts, definitely.
You pinch it. Right.
No, there's another one.
Here. Take that shit pen. What am I writing?
Darling, just hold on. You have a new page here.
Sorry, love. Fucking hell.
How would you say your relationship with like brotherhood and that concept of brotherhood has changed through your career?
As I've got older, really, you know, my responsibility has changed with my sisters and me little brother. Yeah, I think it gets, I seem to understand it more as I get older. I'm currently trying to have a conversation with my twin sisters to go to sick form. They don't want to go. through experience and through doing it longer and kind of being older, a little bit more mature, I suppose. Yeah.
Mature, I suppose.
Yeah. Well, I tried to be. Yeah. I mean, as a brother, I have to be, you know what I mean? So.
Yeah, we're all trying to adult in some respect.
Exactly.
Do you still have a thing when you're like, oh my God, am I actually adulting well today?
Like whenever I'm with my son Freddie and whenever I'm having like those kind of conversations about school with the girls, my sisters and that, I feel like then I've got my adult head on. I have to have credibility in those conversations, you know what I mean? But I definitely still act like a lad at times.
Ever gotten from a fan?
I got a really nice Adidas jumper once, pretty random, but
what
it's
did
nice.
You get?
A really
Adidas,
nice
Adidas.
Oh, sorry.
A pair of sneakers?
No, a jumper. Oh, a sweater. You know.
Could they be more English, America? Could they? The way that you look when your steps make that much noise. Shh, I got you
all figured out. You need everyone's eyes. Smileys.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, because that heart is so shit. I am so shit at doing them, so.
Thank you so much. I will get the appointment
right
now.
Not like.
Reckon the set.
You don't really see, like. You don't really, like, draw a pattern to, you know, different parts of the world to do with. Like different people being, you know, getting more attention. It's just like they're kind of just crazy everywhere, and that's what we love about our fans.
That was a moment that wheelchair Ollie. Oh, you got to pick them up just to say hello. You got little crowds that go beep, beep, beep. They got
people.
talking to some of the fam here about if they could describe you in one word earlier, and they would one answer stood out to me: sunshine. They would just say sunshine.
Ain't that nice? Ain't that nice? He's a lover.
Ooh, your body's like an ocean. I'm devoted to explore you.